Hey guys, so the Portugal Hard Enduro Series is over with XL Agache a few weeks ago, and I wanted to give you some thoughts and what I've learned with the Portugal Hard Enduro Series about myself and my riding. First of all, and it's something that I found out pretty soon, actually, which is my speed. I'm pretty sure that if I could work a lot more on my speed, mainly on the prologues, if I was more aggressive, I could have started in every race in a far better position than I've actually started it, despite all the unfortunate hazards that I had, but that's racing. But it's definitely something that I have to work on, and it's something that I will work on the next coming months to be ready. Namely also on the Loser Like Enduro Championship, and as well for the next year of the Portugal Hard Enduro Series. I want to give a huge shout out to Paulo Moreira and the whole staff of Melissa's team, because they have done a great job with the Portugal Hard Enduro Series being the first one of its kind. Portugal. It has really changed the game in Portugal and the hard enduro scenery, and it has upped the ante for the sport, which is really good, and it's something that we really need since hard enduro has been growing so much on these last few years, and it's something that has to be worked on exactly the same way as the Portugal Hard Enduro Series have been done. Now talking about the races themselves. Well, the long extreme, I have to say, I don't think I've ever suffered that much on the race, even compared with the XL Agache from last year. It was a huge mistake of mine to go do the race without being completely used to the bike. It was a risk, I already knew, I simply didn't knew it was going to come out that badly. Let's say it that way. And I think that even though my case or my situation, I think that no one was actually expecting for the race to be that demanding and that hard, which was something, it was kind of a bit slap for everyone to start with the Portugal Hard Enduro Series. But nonetheless, it was a really good race, a really fun race. About the Chaves Extreme, I love the race. I didn't have the best performance, but still, I gotta say that I really liked the race. The venue was amazing. The race was, it has had some amazing landscapes. Well, despite the rain and the mud, it was a really fun race. I really liked for it because it was completely different from what we are used to here in Porto or in Valongo. It's completely different. And I feel extreme. I gotta say, I think Paul with that one kind of went the extra mile, because the places where the race went through were simply amazing. You had some parts of the course, mainly the Sobidesh from the race, which was stunning. You had some really amazing views, and the course itself was as well completely different from what we are used to here in Valongo, and completely different from what we had in the Chaves. So I think the race itself was really good, really flowy. There was only one issue with the course, because there was one checkpoint which was right after the one big section or one really difficult section, which built up a huge amount of traffic that I've never seen. Even in XL Agache. Lastly, XL Agache. Well, what can we say about XL Agache that hasn't been already said? XL Agache, it's an experience by itself. And this year, it has gone the extra mile as well. Now being part of WES, I think the level went definitely two or three steps up. The course itself was as well staggering. I loved it. I haven't had any moment where there was a huge amount of traffic. I don't know if that's because of the position where I've started with on a starting grid, but even though I don't think there was any huge parts of the course where there could be a huge amount of traffic. I can be wrong, but that was my experience on the race. That itself is a huge evidence that the race is growing and getting better every year, because last year, well, in Coast there was a huge amount of traffic, I have to say. I stood there like 1 hour or something, simply too much. And this year they really took that into account and they avoided parts where it was unnecessary traffic. But nonetheless, the course was super fun, super flowy. You had super fast pits and super tough pits as well. So you had a compromise between both that was really spot on. And I can only say that I have the greatest amount of fun that I've ever had on a race. And I finished it. I'm really stoked about it. And I'm already expecting for next year's edition. It's see you next year, kind of. So that was my take on the Portugal Hard Enduro Series. Let me know in the comments below your opinions about the series, what you found good about it, what you found bad, what could be improved. I think being the first year of this series, the best thing we can do as supporters and fans is give the most amount of feedback to the Malicious team of what was bad, what can be improved, what was great and should keep it up in order to improve this and to push the sport even further. As for me, well, hard enduro season is kind of closing now, it's summer, and clearly time to focus on some different things, but you'll definitely be updated on the next few videos, okay? Cheers!